Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Unsung freedom fighters of India who deserves our salute. Our independence was hard fought, the British ruled over our land for a long time. But then there are heroes, aren't there? There are always heroes. The ones who stand up and fight, some get the spotlight while some stay in the dark and contribute just as much as the others. This bodes true for India's freedom fighter as well. For those who fought equally hard but never got any share of the limelight because they simply never cared. Their only focus was seeing an independent India, but as a citizens of this country, we should know about some of them. First on the list is Mattangini Hazra. Hazra was a part of Quit India movement and non-cooperation movement. During one procession, she continued to advance with the Indian flag even after being shot thrice. She kept shouting, Vande Mataram, Vande Mataram, Vande Mataram. Second on the list is Begum Hazrat Mahal. Begum Hazrat Mahal, she was a vital part of the 1857 Indian Rebellion. After her husband was exiled, she took charge of Awadh and even seized control of Lucknow during the rebellion. Later, Begum Hazrat had to retreat to Nepal where she died. Third is Senapati Bapat. Senapati Bapat, as a leader of the Mulshi Satyagraha, he got the title of Senapati. He got the honor of hosting the Indian flag in Pune for the first time after independence. He had been jailed for public speaking as well for vandalism, after which he turned himself in because a Satyagrahi, he was not supposed to follow the path of violence. Fourth is Aruna Asif Ali. Few have heard about her, but when she was 33 years old, she gained some prominence as she hosted the Indian National Congress flag during the Quit India movement at Gwalior Tank Maidan in Bombay, 1942. Next on the list is O.T. Sriramulu. O.T. Sriramulu, he was an avid supporter and devotee of Mahatma Gandhi. After seeing his dedication towards humanitarian purposes and the nation, Gandhi once said, "If only I have 11 more followers like Sriramulu, I will win freedom in a year." Next is Bhikaji Kama. Bhikaji Kama, also there are numerous roads and buildings named after her around the country. Only few know who she was and what she did. Not only she was a part of the Indian independence movement, she was also a figure for gender equality. She donated most of her personal effects to an orphanage for girls. She also unfurled the Indian flag at the International Socialist Conference at Stuttgart in Germany, 1907. Next is Tara Rani Srivastava. Along with her husband, she led a procession in front of the Sivan police station through he was shot. She bandaged his wounds and kept going forward. By the time she returned, he was died. However, her will to go on was stronger still and she continued to fight, holding the flag high. Next is Kanhaiya Lal Maniklal Munshi. Kanhaiya Lal Maniklal Munshi, also known as Kulpati Munshi, was might active during India's freedom movement, especially the Quit India movement. He was the founder of Bharati Vidya Bhavan. The number of times he was arrested by the British regime showed his dedication and passion for an independent India. Next on the list is Peer Ali Khan. Peer Ali Khan, he was one of the initial rebels of India. Khan was a part of 1857 freedom struggle and among the 14 people who were given capital punishment due to their role in the freedom movement. Even still, his work inspired many who followed. But generation later, his name just faded away. नंबर 10 इज कमला देवी चट्टोपाध्याय। कमला देवी चट्टोपाध्याय, कमला देवी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन टू रन फॉर लेजिस्लेटिव सीट इन इंडिया एंड इंटरेस्टिंगली शी वॉज ऑल्सो द फर्स्ट इंडियन वुमेन टू बी अरेस्टेड बाई द ब्रिटिश रिजाइम। शी प्लेड अ वेरी वाइटल रोल एज अ सोशल रिफॉर्मर एंड ब्रॉट बैक हैंडीक्राफ्ट थिएटर्स एंड हैंडलूम्स टू हेल्प इन अपलिफ्टिंग द सोशल इकोनॉमिक स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ द इंडियन वुमेन। नेक्स्ट इज गरिमेला सत्यनारायण। Garimela Satyanarayana, he was an inspiration for the people of Andhra. As a writer, he used his skill to write influence poems and songs to motivate the people of Andhra to join the movement against the British. Number 12 is Tirupur Kumaran. Tirupur Kumaran. Kumaran was the founder of Desa Bandhu Youth Association. He was killed during a protest march against the colonial government on 11 January 1932 for holding a flag of Indian nationalists that was banned by the British. Through his concussion, the injuries, he was found dead holding the flag. Next is Rajkumari Gupta. Rajkumari Gupta, she and her husband worked with Mahatma Gandhi and Chandrasekhar Azad and plays a very crucial role in the Kakori case as well. She was in charge of supplying revolvers to those involved in the operation. Rajkumari hid the firearms in her undergarments and went to deliver them with a 3-year-old son alongside. Ironically, through on being arrested, she was disowned by her marital home. Next is Lakshmi Sehgal. She was an officer of the Indian Army and was also referred to as Captain Lakshmi. Lakshmi was a World War II veteran and spent time as a prisoner in Burma. When she heard that Bose was recruiting women soldiers as well, she gave her name. She was ordered to form a female regiment called Rani of Jhansi Regiment, where she got the rank of captain. Last one is Birsa Munda. Birsa Munda, he was born on Thursday and therefore named after it. Though he died at the young age of 25, he had some remarkable achievement in his short time. The most notable one being heading the Malarian movement that inspired the tribal belt of modern day